Consider the system of linear equations given by Ax equal to b, where A is the matrix shown here, x is a 5 tuple of variables, x1 up to x5, b is a 3 tuple, 2, 4, and 6. Do you see immediately what values you can assign to x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, so that the system of linear equations is satisfied? You may want to pause the video to look at this more closely. If you don't see a solution right away, writing out the system info might help, and here it is. Now I can rewrite this to an equivalent system. Do you now see what values you can assign to the variables to satisfy these equations? What happens if you set x2 and x4 to 0? So let's do that. Well, if x4 is 0, then x5 is just 2. And if x4 is 0, x1 is just 4. And if x2 and x4 are 0, x3 is just 6. We can certainly set x2 and x4 to other values. And if we do that, we'll get different solutions. But the key is that if I set x2 and x4 to 0, these three variables, the values assigned to them are precisely the right-hand side values of the equations. So is there something special going on here? Well, if you look at the system more carefully, you will notice that in each equation, there is a variable that appears in no other equation, and its coefficient is 1. So in the first equation, I have x5. It doesn't appear anywhere else, and its coefficient is 1. And in the second equation, it's x1. And in the third equation, there are two such variables, x2 and x3. Either one appears only in this equation and having coefficient 1. Now, if you happen to have such a system where each equation has at least one variable that appears in no other equation and its coefficient is 1, then those variables are called basic variables. And the remaining variables are called non-basic variables. And you can easily get a solution by setting all the non-basic variables to 0. And setting the basic variables to the right-hand side. And this is exactly what happened here. We did exactly that. Our non-basic variables are x2 and x4, and our basic variables are x5, x1, x3. Now, the question of whether or not you can always turn a system of linear equations into this form is worth considering, and this is something that we'll address later. But let me rewrite this system a little bit. I'm going to space the variables out, and I'm going to write the variables in a different order, as follows. I'm going to write down the second equation first, and then the third equation second, and with the first equation as the last equation in this new system, where x5 appears before x4. Now, I can write this in matrix form. And if we again use A as the coefficient matrix and B for the right-hand side values, A would be simply this matrix. And X this time will be different because the positions of x4 and x5 have interchanged. Alright, now focus on the matrix A. If you look at each row of A, you'll notice that the leftmost non-zero entry is 1. Here, here, and here. Notice that for each of these ones, called a leading one, if you look above or below it, the values are all 0. Also, the leading one in the second or higher row is to the right of the leading one in the previous row. And we'll add one more property which is true for this A, but vacuously. Any row containing only zeros is at the bottom of the matrix. Well, clearly A satisfies the condition because there's no rows of zeros. If A had rows of zeros, they would appear at the bottom. A matrix having this particular form is said to be in reduced row echelon form. So let me write down the conditions here. So these are the three conditions for a matrix to be in reduced row echelon form. Now, if a matrix satisfies all these except the first one partially, that is, if the column containing the leading one only has entries below it to be equal to 0, but not necessarily those that are above it, then it is said to be in row echelon form without the word reduced. As we have seen in our example here, if you have a system AX equal to B with A in reduced row echelon form, then a solution can be read off very quickly, provided that A doesn't have a zero row whose corresponding right-hand side is non-zero. Because in such case, if A has a row of zero, where the right-hand side corresponding to that row is non-zero, you are basically having an equation that says 0 equal to alpha for some non-zero alpha, which is impossible. And recall that the way you read off a solution is, for any variables that do not correspond to the leading ones, you set them to 0. And then for the variables corresponding to the leading ones, you set them to the right-hand side values. In the next video, we'll look at a mechanical procedure for solving a system AX equal to B that brings it to an equivalent system RX equal to D, where R is in reduced row echelon form. Once we have such a procedure, solving system of linear equations might appear quite straightforward. But it turns out that there are interesting issues that arise when you try to program a computer to solve system of linear equations. Those issues are discussed in more advanced courses in linear algebra.